So I was a little kid. I went to the bathroom a whole lot. No one sent me the memo to just go in the pool. But I would, you know, I'd go to the bathroom and she'd send somebody after me, and then they would, we'd walk up together and he would tell Frankie, yeah, he's just standing down there in a hot shower. I'd be like, I was a little kid just standing under the hot shower, missing practice. So I'd get 500 butterflies. So I started breathing to the side because it was easier.
Yeah.
And she said, you know what? I like this, keeps your head low to the water, gets your hips higher in the water. I like it. So she supported me in that style.
Wow. Incredible. And then you kept it and told all the other coaches, I'm not changing that. Is that what happened?
You know, I thought that Marsh is going to try and change it.
Yeah. I would have thought so for sure.
I thought that, I thought John Trimbley would try to change it. JT did not. I think Marsh recognized it was too late in my career.
Mm.
And, but that's why I breached the side. And I just so our swim nerds out there, Nathan, just want to shout out to you, buddy. Just for our swim nerds out there, I got to say this, the changes in my stroke with Marsh, my hands entered together. If you're not watching when I recovered on my butterfly, my hands would come together like Mikhail Gross, big stroke, lots of reach. So from touching to my shoulders, I was getting nothing, no forward motion. So Marsh had me enter my hands out just outside my shoulders. It seemed counterintuitive because I was taking two extra strokes per 50. He explained, Mel, here's what inertia is. So he explained that he wanted to keep my forward energy. He flattened my stroke a little bit. And I started, instead of turning my head dramatically to the side, I was turning it just about, you know, 45 to 50, you know, just, and I was getting a breath out of my underarm. And so he did these slight changes and they were miraculous.